Zara here from Suffolk Libraries, back with another coffee table crafts. Today I will be showing you how to make your very own Harvest Scarecrow. Now all you will need to get started with is a toilet roll tube inner, some coloured paper for your clothes, for your scarecrow, some tissue paper patches cut out for just patches on the clothes and on the hat. You'll need an A4 sheet of coloured paper. I'm using brown, or you can use black, it's entirely up to you. All you do to get this size, which is A5, is your A4 sheet, fold in half, so you see, fold it in half, and then get a grown-up, or it depends on your age and ability, cut it in half, and you will end up with an A5 size sheet, which is what you need. Then you will need wet PVA style glue and a pot and spatula, some clothes pegs, just literally to hold the scarecrow's clothes on while it's drying. Very importantly for his face, you will need googly eyes and some colouring pens. I've got black, red and pink, a pencil, a ruler, some scissors and possibly a grown-up assistant. Now for hair, you can either use this craft raffer, which looks a bit like straw, or you could use tissue paper shredded, entirely up to you. And finally, some little embellishments to put on the scarecrow's hat. So if you've got any like felt shapes, or maybe where you've got some little craft pieces cut out, okay, anything like that really. So to start off with, you get your toilet roll tube inner. Now I've skipped ahead slightly, I've cut out his clothes. So you want the clothes to be, if you see, about half the height of your scarecrow, okay? And then from there, you just draw on your sheet a straight line across, and either you or your grown-up assistant cut out your strip, your coloured strip. Now then from there, I'll just move this little scarecrow out of the way a second, just so you can see. From there, you want to coat the back of your scarecrow's clothes with wet style PVA glue. Okay, now you then want to, I'll just show you this way, you then want to roll it, while it's wet you can move it around still too, roll it round your toilet roll tube. So if you see, I've cut it so it's slightly longer and slightly overlaps. Okay, now just to hold it in place while it is drying, that's where the clothes pegs come in handy. Okay, so if I just move that one there, I'm going to try and keep the crease stick line towards the back of the scarecrow. So while that is drying, you can start on the face. Okay, so first of all, I would start off with drawing on the mouth. So this is your face area here, so you want to draw like a smile line, and then just lines across, if you see, like stitching. Okay, so you end up with a little smile. Then from there, they will need some nice rosy cheeks, so just some little round pink circles at the corners of the smile, the little rosy cheeks. And then a nose, I'm going to have an orangey red, so sort of a carrot style nose, so a triangle just in the middle there. Okay, so you've got the nose, I'll just put those pens to one side. Now there, from there, you want these eyes, or his or her eyes on. Just tip those out. So the best thing to do is get your googly eye and put some PVA glue on the back. the eyes in place. So you want to do that with both the eyes. So he can see, he or she can see. Okay, so you've got the face on there, and we'll just put this to one side just to dry. So from there, we will make the hat. So I think for this scarecrow, I will use a black hat. So best thing to do is first of all, fold it over in half. Okay, so you see, fold it over in half there. And then fold it over in half the other way. Then go back to the long ways. So you fold it to the short side. Then from there, from that middle fold, fold down to a triangle. Okay, so if you see, fold to a triangle there. So you put your flap. So it doesn't go all the way down, so you're going to end up with this lip. And do that both sides. Okay, top of the point. Then fold the front sheet up to make the brim of the hat, then turn it over and fold the other side up to make the other side of the hat. Now, if you then put your fingers inside, you should see you're able to have your hat, 3D hat. So we want to put a little flower or some sort of embellishment on the hat. Okay, so what are we going to use? I think for this one I might use a felt flower. So I put some PVA glue on the back of felt flower and dab it onto the hat. So he's got a little flower on his hat. And oh, you know what? Let's put a butterfly on there too. See if a butterfly has landed on his hat. You can decorate it however you wish. This is obviously your toilet paper scarecrow. So there we go. We've had a little butterfly land on his hat there too. So I know it's still dry, and we can put a patch on his clothing. So what colour should we use? It's different to the purple. How about a green? I'm just going to cut it down. So my patch is a little bit big. Let's cut those down. So yet again, a little bit of glue on the back. And wherever you wish. Looks more effective if you put it at a slight angle. And get your black pen just to give it the look of stitch lines, so as if it's actually a patch that's been stitched on. See that? So I'll take the pegs off, and we need to do the hair, don't we, for the scarecrow. So I'm going to use some tissue paper this time. This one, some coloured tissue paper. Oh, it's very messy. Right, so what you want to do is just get some glue inside your hat, probably a nice thick layer, just so it all sticks, really. You can get your hair. See, I'm just putting it in, sticking it in. Scarecrow's hair isn't all tidy, is it? It's all a bit messy. So give it a bit of flair. Okay. And then you're ready to put your scarecrow's hat on. Give it a slight angle if you want as well. And ta-da! your toilet roll in the tube scarecrow. Hope you've enjoyed today's craft. Obviously I'm still doing these once a fortnight here at Lakenheath Library, but by all means please do check out our Facebook page, Lakenheath Library's Facebook page, Lakenheath Friends of Lakenheath Library Facebook page. We also have a Suffolk Library's home Facebook page, which all of the videos that have been created will be on there for you to view, as well as our YouTube page, which is Suffolk Libraries. And if you go on there, and you can subscribe, and you will get alerts to all of the latest videos from all of my colleagues across Suffolk Libraries. In the meantime, till I'm back again, stay safe and hope you've had fun, and see you soon. Take care. Bye-bye.